SnowTrax is brought to you by Polaris. Think outside. Ski-Doo. Winter lovers, get out there and experience that Ski-Doo feeling. And by Hercules Tire. Ride on our strength.
We're in beautiful Kelowna, British Columbia. It is one of the nicest places in all of Canada. And we're heading to Grizzly Lodge. John's here with us. John and I have ridden together lots of times at Snowshoot where we get to ride next to your sleds, but it's been a couple of years since we've ridden, so we're coming out here to have some fun.
I met AJ from a mutual friend of ours. For me, the chance to go to West Yellowstone to do the shoot for the magazines. After that, started going year after year. Been riding since, and it's been awesome.
So getting up to Grizzly Lodge is a unique experience. It's like a 40-kilometer drive-in down this. It's a gnarly logging road. Are kind of headed in, you're thinking, am I going the right place? Because we're a long flipping ways back in here.
We followed them up to their staff lot, and from there we got in the pickup truck with Trax and brought us up to the lodge.
We made it. We are a long ways up here. We're at probably one of the best places to mountain ride in the world. Now we gotta get checked in, and that's the other cool part about being here. It's not just great riding, it's like first class accommodations across the board, from like amazing chefs to just wicked hospitality. If I'm going somewhere to relax, I want the riding to be just as good as the comfort side of things, and it is a Grizzly Lodge, so I'm excited to be here.
You can ride in so many areas in BC. I mean, you can have crazy powder days. You can have days with a little less snow. So what we try and do is create an experience within the lodge itself that makes it so that no matter what the conditions, your sled broke down, you're not feeling good, you're hanging out at the lodge and you're enjoying yourself, no matter what. And that's the service our staff provide: food, our hot tub, our sauna, our massage therapist. All the amenities we have here, we put our 100% effort into to make it so that no matter how the snow is out there, you're enjoying yourself inside these walls. And we're all, you know, as a whole, the whole team, we're proud of that fact.
The beauty about this is if you've ever been out to the mountains before, you get in the truck in the morning, you load up the trailer, you gotta drive 30, 40 minutes to the staging area, then you need to make a anywhere from 30 minute to an hour ride up to get in the really good powder. Grizzly Lodge, you don't have to. You are on the snow right as soon as you fall out the back door. They set out lunches for you to grab and, you know, put in a bag, toss in your sled and head out, so you got food when you're out on the trail. You break anything, they got parts here. You need fuel, they've got it. You need oil, they've got it. A lot of places in the mountains that you go to, you're thrown into, I would say probably right away, intermediate riding. And that can be intimidating for a lot of people, because a lot of folks like me come from the flatlands, and if you don't have a lot of experience in the mountains, side milling a line with some trees down at the bottom can be super intimidating, and you sometimes do get target fixation. Coming up here to Grizzly, one thing that I think is a hallmark of this ride area is that you go out into very tame, very mild riding right away.
One of my good buddies, Adam, he's been coming here for 5 years, and he always rants and raves about the place, says it's unbelievable. He's 100% right. Definitely feel like this place, I can bring a couple of the older fellows that we ride with, and you know, they'd love to get out on the mountains, but not in any specific scenario, but this one would fit for sure, because everything's taken care of. They get taken up here, the riding is very open. It's a diverse place. They can ride no problem. I could bring my wife. Anybody could come up here and have a ton of fun.
You don't want to turn people off by going too extreme, too quick. Let people build into it, let your skills grow, and then eventually you're ready for that advanced riding. And you can come to Grizzly and get that as well. But the beautiful part is that it's real easy, real tame right from the get-go. And I appreciate that because it gives all of us flatlanders who maybe haven't had so much experience something that we can really sink our teeth into and a place that you can grow from. And Grizzly goes from mellow to extreme. It's just so nice to be able to ride out on a nice, smooth trail that's easy, gentle. You know, you get to where you want to play and you don't have to go crazy. Now, Grizzly Lodge is not just, you know, a really cool spot that's way up in the mountains. You know, you can go out and ride, but it's also first-class accommodations. When I talked to Tom, he was telling me, you can come here and you get a little bit of rain, or say the snow isn't as good as you expected it to be. He said, we still have every person who leaves here say they had a great time. They have a masseuse on site. You can get a massage before you go out and ride in the morning and after if you want. They just schedule it in, it goes right on your tab and you pay for it when you leave.
We try and make it as easy as possible so that really all you need to do is book your flight, book your trip with us, and you're done. You go through our website, put a booking inquiry through, you want a stay and ride package. We let you know what's available. Once you get booked on with that, basically what you're getting is an airport shuttle, Kamloops or Kelowna. We're doing meals and accommodations, snowmobile rental, guiding, avalanche safety gear, and orientation on avalanche safety, all in the package price. So we get you right at the airport, bring you right up to our staging area. We either get you in our truck on tracks or in a snowmobile, and we get you to the lodge. If you want to go even further with it, we offer rental gear. So outside of the avalanche safety gear, you've got boots, pants, jacket, helmet. All that stuff is also available if you want to just make it as easy as possible and show up in your running shoes and your hoodie.
The food is absolutely phenomenal. They have a chef full time here, and he is doing an absolutely kick butt job. It is top shelf, first rate, you're well fed. They set out lunches for you to grab and, you know, put in a bag, toss in your sled.
The accommodations here are unreal. Everybody talks to you first name basis. They take care of you. Any food that you have here is top shelf. Anything you need, they have it. You never have to go back down to the truck. Luckily, I needed a new pair of goggles this morning. Went down to the store in the front of the lodge. They got me set up, brand new set of goggles. Or they just put it on your tab. You don't have to pay for it up front or anything like that. When you leave, you take care of it, and that's it.
My experience at Grizzly Lodge has been amazing. I've realized that having a lodge right in the mountains takes away a lot of the things that detract when you're at a mountain riding experience. That morning gear up, put the sleds in the trailer, drive somewhere, ride 45 minutes in. Those are the things I don't want to do. I don't go to an all-inclusive resort so that I can jump in a car and drive to the beach. I go there because the beach is right there. And Grizzly Lodge, the riding is right there. It's right here. It is 5 minutes away and you are in the powder. And when you return, it's 5 minutes out and you're in the hot tub.
Anybody could come up here and have a ton of fun.
Yeah, you can get out there.
The trip so far, honestly, it's been awesome. Excellent hospitality here, excellent place to stay. Food's fantastic, the riding's great, the guides are awesome. The owner, he's a great guy. Everybody makes you feel at home right away. You know, you're comfortable, you're not, you know, on edge or anything like that. Absolutely love the place, and I definitely recommend it to anybody. It's well worth it.
And if you just want to sit around the lodge all day, you're gonna have a blast. So get your butt out here, come out to BC, ride these mountains, and you know what? The biggest problem you're gonna have, you're gonna wanna come back every single year.
Trail Tech is sponsored by Princess Auto. Ideas, tools.
You know, I've always been the type of guy who likes to drive a truck with a little bit of a lift on it. Along with that, I like the right tires and rims to give it the proper stance. But when it comes to winter driving, those big tires and rims, they don't always perform so well. I geared up my Ford F-250 with a setup of Envy Bronze 20-inch rims mounted to a 35-inch TIS Hercules TT1 mud tire. These tires handle very well on the road, exceptionally well in the mud and dirt, and clean out because of a strategic tread pattern designed to expel anything the spring, summer, and fall can throw your way. But when winter comes, this is where I look for a premium snow-rated tire to keep me safe and also not destroy my nice aluminum summer rims from all that road salt. I've been running Hercules Avalanche TT winter tires on my trucks for the past three winter seasons, and I haven't looked back for a moment. In fact, having a Snowpeak winter tire on my truck has been probably the best decision in the winter when it comes to driving I've made in a long time. The Avalanche TTs that I'm running today are mounted to my stock 250s 18-inch rims and are available in a very wide range of sizes. These 275 70 18s run around the 33.5 inch diameter mark, and while they do change the look of my truck, I'm quite happy to trade my summer off-road stance for a winter's worth of safety and controlled driving. The zigzag circumferential grooves actually hold the snow in the tread, something that I wasn't aware makes for better snow on snow traction. The narrow tread width actually optimizes winter driving performance and is the complete opposite of my massive 12.5 inch wide TT1s. So to prove to you with actual fact, I'm going to take these tires out and put them through a bunch of different situations instead of just telling you what I think about them. This way, you'll actually see how they perform. And the first place can be a little bit controversial, but for four-wheel drive vehicles, I don't leave my truck in four-wheel drive all winter long. Dry parking lots can be terrible for crabbing on your four-wheel drive system, and really there are times that you have clear roads and two-wheel drive is adequate with a winter tire. Take, for example, driving uphill on a plowed and sanded road. The TT1 will slip and slide where the Avalanche TT grips and doesn't cause the traction control system to engage, slowing my momentum and eventually putting me in a must-use four-wheel drive situation. Now, the obvious area of comparison is stopping. I'm not going to get out with a measuring tape and see just the exact distance that these vehicles stop in because the situations will obviously be a little bit different each time. But you're going to be able to tell right away, and the seat of the pants feel when I'm driving, is that the winter TT tires stop so much faster. And I'm not beating up on the TT1s. It's just not designed for harsh winter driving scenarios like the Avalanche TT is. At backroad speeds, the anti-lock brakes are engaged and pulsing continuously with the mud tires. While I will still feel the anti-lock brakes kick in on the Avalanche TTs, it's precise. I can still be in complete control and I feel the ground gripping force of the superior winter design slowing me in a fraction of the time. And let's be honest, it's usually the panic stops when someone pulls out in front of you or you come around a corner and a vehicle's in the ditch that you need to jump on the brakes. And with the Avalanche TT, I know that I'm getting the best stopping that I can, even in the harshest winter conditions. Now, the third area for comparison is cornering. And if you've ever driven in the winter, I know you know exactly what I'm talking about. Heading into a corner, it's snowy and the front end lets go and starts to push. At this point, there's not a lot to do except try your best to slow down and not go into the ditch or hit something. The Avalanche TT is not just a little bit better, it's so noticeable and increases winter driving confidence exponentially. This is only exaggerated when it's a paved main road or highway surface and you encounter freezing rain or black ice. I've been there and the Avalanche TT provides the best possible grip. It also features stud pinholes so that you can stud your tires if it's legal in your area. Studs will take all the attributes of the Avalanche TT and increase them significantly, increasing grip, decreasing stopping distance, and helping you to feel more confident no matter the road conditions. Now, it's also pretty important to talk about trailering with your truck, because when it comes to us sledders, we do this on a pretty regular basis. When towing a trailer, the added weight can drastically affect the attitude of your tow vehicle and can put you in a potentially hazardous situation when winter conditions get severe. Traction and control become exponentially more important when towing a trailer, and this is where the Avalanche TT truly does shine, keeping you planted and in control when you need it most. While the benefits of a true winter tire over a mud terrain are pretty obvious, the reality is, even over an all-terrain tire, winter tires have massive benefits that are gonna pay off in the long run. And that's why I don't even question it. I put winter tires on my work trucks and my personal vehicles each and every winter, because when it comes down to it, safety, that's just not an option.
SnowTrax has been brought to you by Arctic Cat. Share our passion. Udaway Tourism. Snow-covered landscapes to explore. And by FXR. Brings you more.
I have been involved in this industry my entire life, and I can count on one hand the number of times in all those years that a sled that hasn't been changed year after year has remained a favorite year after year. Polaris' 2024 XCR 650 is one of those sleds. One thing that sets the XCR 650 apart from pretty much every other sled in its class is that it is, in fact, a 650, not a 600. And that is one of the most endearing qualities about this snowmobile. This 650 engine makes anywhere from 130 to 145 horsepower, depending on who you talk to. So what is the magic in this engine? Well, basically, Polaris is using the Patriot architecture, the same as the 850, just with smaller holes in it, making a little bit less horsepower. But the broad power range is the same. When you ride a Polaris 850, you notice that the power starts right off engagement, and it pulls hard all the way to the full shift. Well, the 650 is exactly the same. It's just got less power. So out back, you're gonna find a 128-inch version of Polaris' Pro CC skid frame, and you're asking yourselves, why is it a 128, not a 129? It's because the track is a 0.252 pitch track. So that's really the only difference. It's not because Polaris thinks 128 is better somehow. The pitch of the track that they chose to use, their competition pitch track, is just different. There's a different driver up in the front as well. It feels the same as a 129, so there's really no difference there. This skid frame is really robust and durable. The XCR gets a bunch of extra stiffening bits and pieces and some extra stuff to make it survive the rigors of cross-country racing, if that's what you choose to do with it, and it is capable of that. The Matrix platform uses Polaris's proven race IFS front suspension system, and it's no secret to anyone who watches our show that we all agree this is the best front end in the industry in terms of front end ride quality, bump handling, and just general handling overall. It carves corners accurately and gives you tons of confidence as you're cornering in all conditions. Another big secret to that, though, is these Walker Velocity Series shocks. These are considered or called high-low, which means they have high and low speed compression adjustability. They're just a really great shock, especially when combined with this front end that we make no beans about being best in industry. That is the most endearing aspect of a Polaris Matrix of any kind, but especially the XCR. While there are many aspects of a snowmobile that are not subjective, there are aspects of a snowmobile that are very subjective, and one of those aspects is ergonomics. What fits me may not fit you, but there is something to be said for just subjective ergonomics. I like how this feels, and that makes it the best for me, and I can't argue with that. What I can do is say that Polaris ergonomics on this Matrix package have always fit me extremely well. I love how it's laid out. I love the seat. I love the seat height. I love the relation between my feet, my knees, my hips. Everything fits properly. The handlebars, all the switch gear is right where you want it to be. The handlebars are a good width, they're a good shape. It all just works. There has been so much talk in the industry recently about features and technology and included stuff on the sleds that you're getting. And this is, I think, another area that is very subjective. Some people care about features. Some people care a lot about technology. Some people want the highest tech stuff they can get, no matter what it is. And other people are beginning to see that maybe sometimes technology takes away from the purity of riding a snowmobile. And I would agree on both counts. I think that there is technology that works great and is very valuable, and I think there's technology that just distracts from the joy of riding. Polaris has done a great job, in my opinion, of balancing that out. The 7S display is widely considered the best
full-featured digital touchscreen display in the industry. It's not intrusive, it's not so in your face. The features that it has, you can use them or you don't have to use them. It works great just as a basic gauge, but it also has those other things built into it if you want to use them. And with all of that said, there is one thing that we need to talk about, and that is general overall build quality. What I mean by build quality is when you receive your sled, are there problems? Are there going to be issues with it? Are there things that are going to go wrong? Is it going to have to end up back at the dealer? And that is one thing Polaris has had trouble with. We can't lie about that or ignore it. It is the truth. And that's something that they are working very hard to improve upon for this season. And I think that they're taking the right steps towards that. But time will tell. And that's something that if you're going to buy a Polaris, you have to understand. You're taking a little bit of a risk that you're not sure what's going to happen. I have great confidence that Polaris has fixed those problems. But again, we shall see. So what is it about the XCR that makes it such a pleasurable sled to ride, that makes it a favorite among so many people? We've covered off a lot of those topics. There's so many things about this sled to love. And year after year, even though Polaris hasn't changed it a whole lot, it still remains equally as fun. And I think what that says is that they nailed it the first time with this sled. This is a sled in the 600/650 class that's darn near impossible to beat. And it's definitely one that is always at the top of my list of sleds that I want to ride every time I go out riding.